Nah, I'm just kidding. It still works. I was gonna do bagpipes, but for some reason I just can't do a. See?
Put the copper shielding tape all over the black tape that was inside the body of the aircraft. I also took some time and put some on the GPS on the other side. Place any screws you took out from this level and screw them in nice and tight so that the board doesn't move. And we're on our way, one third of the way done. On the next board that has to be reassembled, there are 4 6-pin receptors that have to go on to the bottom board. You'll see them all in the corners. Make sure you line that up right and then push gently, keeping your eye on where they are to make sure they all go into the spot, because they're important for the sensor board that's below it. Reconnect any of the ESCs you may have unplugged to get that board moved up and out of the way. I unplugged 3. And these antennas were wrapped around the battery in the bottom of the aircraft. I just didn't like them sitting there, so I poked a hole and pulled them through, so hopefully that would be better reception for the transmitter or your phone in that case. Next thing, I wanted to test it, make sure it worked, and lo and behold, there it was. So place your last couple screws in, and we are now almost 99% done. Now reconnect your camera and screw that in, and then go through with all the remaining screws and put them back where you found them. Otherwise, you'll have a lopsided little quadcopter. It's bad enough it doesn't fly now. Watch it fly lopsided, right? Right. And finally, place the cap to put the GPS panel antenna back in place, and we're good to go.
So after I posted that video asking for a little help from people, a lot of people volunteered some information about the Onago, especially a man named Kevin Palavec. I hope I said that right, Palavec. You can see his comments on that video down below. He also linked me to a couple of his videos. I'll put that in the description along with the link to his channel. He explained to me a couple things on here that I thought was interesting. First of all, as someone else mentioned too, who I'm not by the computer right now, so the antenna thing that was on this is a panel antenna, and it's meant to connect to the little stubs that I showed previously, and you get your GPS signal from there. Now I was gonna attach it with wires, and I decided, I don't know if I have the exact wires, I'm sure all it is a wire, it doesn't really matter, but I figured, you know what, I'm gonna give it a go like this and leave it. The second thing Kevin said that was very interesting, well, he said a lot of interesting things, but this will connect to Mission Planner. Why is that important? Stand by. If you don't know what Mission Planner is, it's been used for years for the APM 2.6 and the Pixhawks, which is currently the flight controller du jour by 3DR. And this will connect to that. And what does that mean? You bet you thought I was gonna switch you on you again, huh? No, I'm not doing that. That means that we can talk to this thing. And one of the biggest things I think was strange about this is that when you get a drone, they always give you a method to calibrate the compass and the, I don't know, the thing that keeps it steady. I forgot the name of it already. But they give you a way to calibrate two things. The compass and the, I hate getting old. So you'll plug this into Mission Planner. This, I believe if I'm correct, and Kevin, if you're watching, you can correct me where I'm wrong. The baud rate to talk to this is 38,400. You'll plug it in, you'll turn on Mission Planner, or connect with Mission Planner, and then you'll be able to do a calibration of the compass and that other thing, which I'll put right down here after I look it up because I'm not near my computer. It stands to reason that some of these fly so bad that they just, you know, it was never recalibrated for the areas. And I mean, think about it. China's on the other side of the world. It's upside down, you know? This thing thinks it's supposed to fly upside down because that's the last time it was calibrated over in China, right? So, of course you gotta recalibrate it for like where I am on the East Coast. Magnetic points and stuff. This is what it sees. Second thing is, I wasn't quite sure because I didn't really inquire too far into what Kevin was saying, but probably could change some parameters in this too. This is, according to Kevin, this is a Pixhawks, a PX4 board, which is like some mini Pixhawks board, if I remember correctly, which means it does have parameters, which means you can check it. It also has flight logs that you can tap into and download. So there's also a card in here that I didn't realize. The 4 gigabyte card for, I guess, all the operating system and all that stuff that has to be on there. So that would be interesting to see. So when I do that, I will make another video for that, probably Sunday. I'm gonna take it out and fly it as is to see what happens, and then I'm gonna connect the mission planner, fix it, and then I'll go, and then I'll just come back and do another video about it. Kevin also pointed out that there was a GPS in here, and he gave me a link to it, and I'll leave that down in the description in case you wanna go look and see what it is. I don't know why, it's all Chinese anyway, but who knows, you may read Chinese for all I know. I don't. I know two things, Wong Fu and egg roll. That's it, I know. I'd go far in China, at least I get fat eating. Right? Well, so there you go. All back together again. All ready to test out. So, it was a lot of fun trying to take this apart and put it back together again. My primary reason for doing it was to get the extra shielding in there, because I think that's one of the major problems with it. Second thing is, I'd gotten props. I thought they were gonna work. Unfortunately, not a small enough spacer on that for me to make these work. And they're actually a little tiny bit shorter than what the actual blades are. So if you hold the blade up to that, I'm gonna get my fat finger out of the way. That probably would have worked. It's a shame. I thought there was a spacer, one of these things was gonna work on that, but unfortunately no. But you know, I could always do this with it. Make a couple pinwheels out of it or something. So just to show you, even though you probably saw it throughout the instructions, my little switch, I thought that was gonna go in a little bit better, but as I pushed down, this came back out again, so I don't care. It's still a switch the way it's supposed to be, so bleh. So we turn our switch on, we hit our little button, I just forgot which side the switch went to. It's new. Shush. Turn the switch on. Press Z button. And it's on. Let's see if it actually works. Enter the cockpit. We got a camera. And I'm holding the phone the right way this time. And there's the camera. Where's the camera? Oh. Fat fingers in front of it again. See, we got a camera going on there, so that's good. And ready? Let's sing it together. Highway to the danger zone. Oh, I forgot I had the propellers on there. So there you go. Working as good as any. Not that these propellers are gonna hurt anything. I've already thrown my finger into them 2 times. It doesn't even hurt. So there you go, none the worse for wear. We're gonna take it out flying tomorrow and see how it does. I feel like I wanna tie fishing string around it. I saw someone do that on YouTube and I was thinking, you know what? That's not a bad idea because I don't know what this is gonna do. And if I put about 20 feet of fishing rope tied around it, I think I'll be okay. I think, you know, if anything happens, it's just, because this isn't strong enough to do anything major. That said, with the stack of Fig Newtons standing behind me, somewhere in someone else's apartment, I actually buy them on sale for these people to leave them something nice to eat. They don't like Fig Newtons, but at least it's the thought that counts. Mighty Thor from the beautiful city of Tampa. See ya.